Good afternoon, children. I hope you all are fit and fine and you all are learning through the online teaching. And I hope you all are watching my videos also. So those who are not watching, you start watching because I'm covering your syllabus. So you are to do your work side by side and you have to watch videos also. So children, in the previous video I told you about the generation and the story of computer. The generation of computer started from 1940 to 1956. It was first generation, then second generation, 1956 to 1963, third generation 1964 to 1971. I have explained all these generations in my previous video. Fourth generation computer 1971 to present. And the fifth generation computers present and beyond in future. So we were on fourth generation computers. We were on fourth generation computers. Children, the fourth generation computers are using microprocessor. The fourth generation computers are using microprocessors as they are lightweight and faster. They are lightweight and faster, can store data fast and can process the data with a high speed. The computers which we are using these days, these are fourth generation computers. Examples, these are personal computers like PC, okay, and here examples are also given, the personal computers like the IBM system and HP 3000, and the desktop computers, laptop computers and the tablets, these are also the fourth generation computers. Now come on fifth generation computers, which these computers are, the scientists are deciding, they are planning, they are designing such kind of computers, or in future they will launch them. See, these fifth generation computers are based on artificial intelligence. These computers will be based on artificial intelligence. These are still at the development stage. I told you that the scientists are designing or planning to launch them. So these are still at the development stage. These will take decisions based on the stored data. So an advanced technology will be used to develop such kind of computers. So these were the generation of computers. I hope you all have understood and you all will see this video again to have knowledge about the generations. Now come on the next page about the types of computer. Classification of computer. Children, I sent you one video about the classification of computer in earlier days of your online teaching, in which I told you about the classification and the computers which comes under these classification with the examples. So again we are revising it in your chapter number 1. So computer can be classified on the basis of their size and speed. So here we have the first computer, that is microcomputer. The first category is microcomputers. Microcomputers are small computers whose CPU is a microprocessor and contained on a single integrated circuit chip. These computers are children very small, and these are usually used as personal use. Therefore, they are also called personal computers. They are mainly used in homes. Children, these are very small computers, and the computers which you are using at your home, they are called personal computers. And two main types of these are the laptop and the desktop computers. Moreover, these computers are designed for personal use, and they are also called personal computers. These computers are mainly used in schools, offices, shops, banks, etc. So these computers are given different names according to their use. So you are to understand this, that these computers are designed for, these computers are given different names as per their use. Okay. So example is, come on the example. Come here. See, modern desktop computers, video games, consoles, tablet PCs, and many handheld computers, including the latest high-end mobile phones, can be considered as the examples of microcomputers. So I hope the examples are clear to you all. The laptop computers, video games, and many handheld computers like laptops, and the computers which are designed to fix on the desks like desktop computers. These are microcomputers. So you have to keep these things in your mind. Now come on, workstation. What is a workstation? A workstation is like a personal computer. It is like a PC, but it has more powerful microprocessor and generally a superior quality monitor. I hope workstation is clear to you. It has a superior quality monitor, means the display of these computers are with high resolution, the picture quality is very good, and more powerful microprocessor means the processing speed is very high, storage capacity is also very broad. Workstations are used for engineering applications, desktop publishing, and the software development types of applications that require a moderate amount of computing power and high quality graphics capabilities. So these workstations are used for engineering applications, for engineering works, for desktop publishing also, and for developing any kind of software. We use this personal computer, which is known as workstation. Mini computer. Second category is mini computer. Mini computer came into existence in the 1960s. So these computers came in contact with people in 1960s when the mainframe computers were very expensive. Mini computers were powerful and reasonably priced, so users switched over to these. As mainframe computers were very costly, so people, they were in the favor of mini computers because of their powerful and reasonable price. So mini computers became less important with the PC becoming so powerful on its own. The mini computers then became less important than the PC becoming so powerful on its own. The present day, the PC is much more powerful and compact compared to the mini computers. Is it clear to you all? You can see the picture given in the on the screen, mini computer. You can see on the screen and the year in which they came into existence was 1960. At that time, mainframe computers were very expensive and mini computers were powerful and reasonable with price. So users switched over. This users, they started using these computers. I hope this is very much clear. The mini computers were powerful and they are of reasonable price. Okay, and they came in the existence in the year 1960s. So this was the second category of computer, mini computer. Microcomputer we have taken, mini computer. Now come to next computer, that is mainframe computer. Mainframe computer are huge computers. You can see in the picture. The size is very big. That can occupy an entire room or even a whole floor. Because they were of big size, they occupy a room or even a whole floor also. So from here, from this sentence, you can imagine the size. A mainframe can accommodate many users at a time. So it was the positive point of mainframe that it can just give chance to many users to use the computers at the same time. The terminals are used to connect a user to this computer. So terminals were used to connect the user to the computer. You can see here many parts. These full room is occupied with the mainframe computer, and the terminals are also here to connect the user to the computer. So what is terminal? Terminal is a device that has a keyboard and a screen integrated into it. By using a terminal, each user can provide inputs to the computer and get the output on his or her monitor. I hope it is clear. The terminal contains a keyboard and a screen with it. And by using the terminal, each user can give instructions to the computer and get the output on the monitor. So, you can see the picture where you are finding the size. I hope these three computers are very, very clear to you all. Come here, supercomputers. As the name specifies, super, it means super, most powerful computers. A supercomputer uses multiple CPUs. You can see in the picture the size of this computer. It used number of CPUs.